Hello friends, welcome to EduTap. Today in this video, we are going to solve all the reasoning questions asked in NABARD Grade A 2017 Phase 1 examination. So let's start. Directions for question number 1 to 3. Question says, each of the friends P, Q, R, S, T and U borrowed different number of books. R borrowed more books than U but less than P. So R has borrowed more number of books than U but less than P. Q borrowed more books than P but not the highest. So Q has borrowed more number of books than P, but Q is not the person who has borrowed the highest number of books. T borrowed less books than U. Okay, so T has borrowed less number of books than U. Here the only person remained is S. So S will come here. P borrowed 53 books. Okay, P has borrowed 53 books. The person who borrowed second lowest number of books borrowed 12 books. Okay, so second lowest number of books borrowed by U and U borrowed 12 books. Here the question is, how many books did T possibly borrow? Whatever number of books T borrow, it should be less than 12 because already U has borrowed 12 number of books. Okay, so in our option, the number which is less than 12 is 10. So our answer for question number 1 should be option 3, 10. Question number 2 is, who among the following borrowed the second highest number of books? Now tell me who has borrowed the second highest number of books. It is Q. So Q has borrowed the second highest number of books. Question number 3 says, if the number of books borrowed by S is 11 more than that of P. So P has borrowed 53 books and S has borrowed 11 more than 53. Okay, so 11 plus 53 is 64. So the number of books borrowed by S is 64. Question is, then how many books did Q possibly borrow? Whatever number of books Q borrow should be in between 64 and 53, isn't it? So the only number which is 64 and 53 given in our option is option 2, 61. So the answer for question number 3 should be option 2. Direction for question number 4. It says, school X had put up the following notice for its students and teachers regarding rules of the term examination which is commencing from 20 March 2017, that is Monday. The condition number 1 is, the project or assignment for any subject of any class should be submitted at least 40 days prior to the term examination for that particular subject. Okay, so the condition number 1 is for students and it says practical or any assignment for that class should be submitted at least 40 days prior to the examination. Okay, now condition number 2 is for teachers. Teachers should stop taking the extra classes before 1 month of the commencement of the term examination. So extra classes should be stopped at least before 1 month of the examination. Condition number 3 says, the students who have not paid their computer lab fees should pay it before 6 March 2017. Okay, so it should be paid 6 March 2017. Now, question is, the following cases were reported to the principal of school X, which one of these should be punished under the given rules? Okay, so case number A says, geography will be the fourth exam for class 9th. Okay, and as we know that examination is commencing from 20 March 2017, then geography will be on 24th March because it is fourth exam. Priya Dandekar, a student of class 9, submitted her assignment for this subject on 16 Feb 2017. But our rule number 1 says, assignment should be submitted at least 40 days prior to the examination. If we count the number of days, then 12 days of Feb plus 23 days of March. Okay, it will come to 35 days. So Priya Dandekar has break the rule number 1, hence she should be punished. Gautam Saxena, a maths teacher of the school, finished all his extra classes by first week of March. But the rule number 2 says all the extra classes or remedial classes should be stopped before 1 month of the commencement of the term examination. Hence Gautam Saxena will also be punished. Case number C says, Ranveer Chauhan paid his computer fees by the mid of February but submitted its receipt to his class teacher on 5th March 2017. So he met the deadline, hence he should not be punished. So answer for question number 4 should be option 5. Both A and B should be punished. Question number 5. Statement says all digs comes under fruits. Okay, so all digs are fruits. Then statement number 2 says some cherries are digs. Okay, so some cherries are digs. Conclusion number 1 says all cherries are fruits. So here you can see that the portion of cherry which I am shading does not come under fruit. Okay, so this conclusion does not follow. Conclusion number 2 says some cherries are fruits. So obviously some cherries comes under fruit as well. So the conclusion number 2 follows. So answer for question number 5 should be option B if only conclusion 2 follows. Question number 6. Statement says some terms are H. Okay, so some terms are H. Okay, no when is term. So there is no relation between when and term. All kites are H. Okay, so kites comes under H. Conclusion number 1 says all kites being term is a possibility. Now see, I can draw kites all here as well. Okay, there is no problem to draw kites here. So conclusion number 1 is true because it is possible to draw kites here. Conclusion number 2 says all vans can never be H's, but there is no relation between van and H. Okay, so I can draw van here as well, but it says can never be, so this conclusion does not follow. Hence answer for question number 6 should be option A if only conclusion 1 follows. Question number 7. Statement says no river is candle. So there is no relation between river and candle. All axes are candles. So all the axes comes under candle. And there is no relation between jack and river. Okay. Conclusion number 1 says all jack being candles is a possibility. So obviously I can write jack here as well. Okay. There is no problem to write jack here. So conclusion number 1 is true. No axe is river. So obviously all the axes comes under candle and there is no relation between river and candle. No candle can be river, hence no axes can also be river. So conclusion number 2 also follows. So question number 7, the answer for question number 7 is option E if both conclusion 1 and 2 follows. Direction for question number 8. College H is known for having its cutoff for admission above 90%, but this year the cutoff was 81%. Question is, which of the following can be reason for College H having the cutoff at 81% this year? Okay, this year. Reason number 1 is the university to which College H is affiliated has increased the admission fee substantially for all colleges. See, here keyword is given, that is all colleges. Fees is not increased only for College H but for all the colleges. Therefore, this cannot be the sole reason to drop in the cutoff. Because the fees is increased for all the colleges, not for that college only. Okay, now second reason is 2% seat of College H remained vacant last year. Okay, as some students migrated to other college within the first month of commencement of the classes. Okay, this vacant seats are of last year, not for this year. There is nothing to do with the vacant seat of last year with this year's cutoff. Okay, this reason also ruled out. Reason number 3 is the evaluation of paper was very strict. Okay, this year thereby reducing the top scorers percentage to 65%. Now see, here we have given that the cutoff for this year is 81%. Then how can be the topper score 65%? Topper score cannot be 65% because already we have given that the cutoff for this year is 81%. Therefore this reason is also ruled out. Now few faculties of College H resigned at short notice this year, leading to increase in load of the remaining faculties. Here it is telling about the load of remaining faculties which is increased due to resignation of few faculties. So this is not in relation with the cutoff. Now as we can see that none of the option is valid, or we can say valid for this particular scenario. So answer for this question should be option 5. None of the above option. Directions for question number 9 to 11. It says point B is 10 meter to the north of point C. Okay, so if you take point C here, then point B will be here 10 10 meter to the north of point C. Point J is 7 meter to the east of point B. Okay, point K is 5 meter to the west of point C. So point K will be here, 5 meter to the west of point C, and point S is 12 meter to the south of point K. Okay, so point S will be here. Now point T is 5 meter to the east of point S. So point T will be here, 5 meter to the east of point S. Now if you draw diagram neatly, then somehow it will look like this. Now question number 9 says, if Suman walks 7 meter to the east of point T. Now Suman is walking 7 meter east of the point T, then she takes a left turn and walks for 10 meters to reach point X. Okay, it is X. So she has walked for 7 meter. Okay, and she takes a left turn and she walks for 10 meters to reach point X. Now question is, how far and in which direction should she walk to reach point J? Now see, the total distance between these two points is 10 plus 12. Okay, so 10 plus 12 is 22. Suman has already covered 10 meters, so the remaining distance, that is from point X to J, is 12 meters, and she has to go in north direction to reach point J. So the answer for question number 9 should be option 2, north, 12 meter north. Now question number 10 is, in what direction is point S with respect to point C? So point S is here and point C is here, so S is in southwest to point C. So the answer for question number 10 is option 2. Question number 11 says, how far is point T from point B? So the point T is here and point B is here, and we know that the total distance between these two points is 10 meters plus 12 meters. Okay, so the answer should be 22 meters. So answer for question number 12, question number 11 should be option 1, 12 meters. Directions for question number 12 to 16. Puzzle says, 10 people are sitting in two parallel rows containing 5 people each in such a way that each person seated in a row faces another person of the other row. Okay, in row 1, A, B, C, D and E are seated and all of them are facing north. Okay, and in row 2, J, K, L, M and N are seated and all of them are facing south. Okay, all of them are from different countries, that is Venezuela, Argentina, Zaire, Poland, Germany, Venezuela, Russia, Brazil, France and Italy. Okay, so let's start the puzzle. Puzzle says, A sits third from the left end of the row, and we know that A sit in the row number 1. Okay, so third from the left, that is first, second and third. So A will sit here. Only one person sit between A and B. Okay, so there are two possibilities. B can be here or can be here. So let's try to solve this puzzle by taking both the possibilities. Now only two people sit between B and the one from Russia. Okay, so if B is here, then the one from Russia will sit here. Okay, in this condition the one from Russia will sit here. Now the one who faces the one from Russia sits to the immediate left of K. Okay, so in this condition the one who is facing the person from Russia is sitting here, so K will come here, and in this condition K will come here. The next is, only one person sit between K and the one from Argentina. So in this condition Argentina will come here. Okay, Argentina, and in this condition Argentina can either be here or here. But in the next line we have given that the one from Argentina sits at one of the position to the left of K. Okay, so Argentina will come left to K, so Argentina will come here in this condition. Okay, next is, D sits to the immediate left of the one who faces the one from Argentina. Okay, the person who is facing Argentina is sitting here, so D will come here in this condition, and in this condition D will come here. Okay, now only two person, sorry, here we have missed the one line. The one from Holland sits to the immediate right of the one from Argentina. Okay, if Argentina is here, then Holland will sit here. Holland, and in this condition, Holland will come here. Okay. Now, only two people sit between the one from Holland and N. Okay, if Holland is here, then N will come here in this condition, and in this condition, N will be here. Now, C is not from Germany. But here the line is given that the one from Germany is an immediate neighbor of the one who faces N. Okay, so the one who is facing N in this condition is B. So B's neighbor will be from Germany. Okay, and in this case, Germany will come here. Now, we have given that C is not from Germany, so C cannot be here, so C will come here, and C cannot come here, so C will come here. But we know that A, B, C, D, and E should sit in row 1, okay, and only one place is left in row 1, so it will be occupied by E in this condition as well. Okay, now the one from Venezuela faces E. Okay, if E is here, then Venezuela will come here. Venezuela. Okay, I am writing in short because there is not much space. Okay, and here Venezuela. Okay, now we have given that only three people sit between the ones from Poland and France. Okay, then there can be two conditions. Okay, if Poland come, the person from Poland sits on the left end, then France, the person from France will sit on the extreme right end. Okay, and if France sit here, then Poland will sit here. Okay, so they both will sit on the extreme ends. Okay, now here we have given that neither B nor C is from either Poland or France. Okay, so B cannot be from France or Poland, and C cannot be from France or Poland. Okay, so we know that France and Poland cannot come in row 1. Okay, so they should be in row 2, but in case 2, if we say this case 2, then we cannot place this condition here, because here only one extreme end is left. Okay, and we need two extreme ends to fulfill this condition, so our this condition gets cancelled. Okay, now we will focus on this condition only. The one from France sits at one of the position to the left of the one from Poland. Okay, so we have said that, we have given that the one from France sits at one of the position to the left of the one from Poland. Okay, so this condition will be valid, and this will not. Okay, so here will be Poland, and here will come France. Okay, now we have given that J sits to the immediate right of L, and J is not an immediate neighbor of the one from Poland. So J cannot come here, so J will come here. Okay, and L will come here. The only person remained is M, so M will sit here. Now J is not immediate neighbor of Poland. More than one person sit between the one from Italy and Brazil. Okay, so more than one person, so Italy and Brazil cannot be the second neighbors. Okay, so the one from Brazil sits at one of the position to the right of the one from Italy. Okay, we cannot write Brazil or Italy here, because it is clearly mentioned that more than one person sits between the one from Brazil and Italy. So to fulfill this condition, we have to write Italy here and Brazil here. Okay, and Italy here and Brazil here. Okay, and the only country left out is Zaire. Okay, so A will be from Zaire. So if we draw our diagram neatly, then it will somehow look like this. Now let's see questions. Question number 12 says, as per the given arrangement, M is related to Holland. Okay, and E is related to Germany. Okay, to which amongst the following is B related to following the same pattern? Here you can see that the same country and persons are given following the pattern. So B will be from Brazil following that pattern. Okay, so question number answer for question number 12 will be option 5, Brazil. Now question number 13 is, which of the following statement is true as per the given arrangement? If you read all these options, then you will come to know that only one option, that is option 1, is true and all others are false. Option number 1 says A is from Zaire, and you can see here that A is from Zaire itself. Okay, so answer for question number 13 is option 1. Question number 14 says, who sits second to the right of L? Okay, so L is here, and who is sitting second to the right of L? M. And if we see all the options, then we will come to know that the answer is option 4, the one who faces D, because M is facing D. So answer for question number 14 will be option 4. Question number 15 says, 4 of the following 5 are alike in certain way based on the given arrangement and thus form a group. Which of the following does not belong to that group? Okay, Holland and Venezuela. Next is Russia and Poland and Argentina. Okay, if you observe, then you will come to know that all the 4, that is Poland, Holland, Argentina and Venezuela, are from row number 2, and only Russia is from row number 1. Okay, and we have asked to find odd one out, so Russia will be odd one out in this question. So answer for question number 15 will be option 3. Question number 16 says, who is from Italy? Okay, so here we can see that the person who is from Italy, and that person is C. Okay, so answer for question number 16 will be option 5. In the next puzzle, we have given that 8 people A, B, C, D, E, F, G and H are sitting around a circular table facing the center. Each of them live in different city, namely Mumbai, Pune, Lucknow, Chennai, Surat, Kochi, Jaipur and Aurangabad. Okay, the one who lives in Mumbai sits second to the right of H. Okay, if you assume H here, then Mumbai will come here. Now, A is an immediate neighbor of the one who lives in Mumbai. So, A can be here or A can also be here. So, let's take another case. In this case, we are taking A at this position, and in this case, we are taking A at this position. Okay, now only 3 people sit between A and the one who is from Chennai. Okay, in this case, Chennai will come here, and in this case, Chennai will come here. Now, we have given that only 2 people sit between the one who lives in Chennai and the one who lives in Lucknow. Okay, so there are only two people between Chennai and Lucknow. So the position of Chennai is fixed in both the cases. In this case, Chennai is here, so Lucknow can't be here, so Lucknow should be here in this case. And in this case, Lucknow can't be here because here already this place is already occupied by Mumbai, so Lucknow should be here. Now F is an immediate neighbor of the one who lives in Lucknow, so in this case F should be here, and in this case F will come here. Now, as many people sit between F and the one who lives in Aurangabad as between F and the one who lives in Chennai. Okay, so let's count how many people live between F and Chennai. Here in this case only one person live between F and Chennai, so there should be only one person between F and Aurangabad as well. Okay, so if F is here, then Aurangabad must be here. In this case as well, there is only one person between F and Chennai, so there must be only one person between F and Aurangabad as well, so Aurangabad should be here in this case. Now, D sits second to the left of the one who lives in Aurangabad. Okay, if Aurangabad is here, in this case, if Aurangabad is here, then D should be here. Okay, because we have said that D should be second to the left of the one who is from Aurangabad. Now, in this case, Aurangabad is here, and according to the situation, D must be here, but this position is already occupied by F. So, this case stands cancelled because we cannot fulfill this condition in this case. Okay. So, now onward, we will focus our attention in this case on this case only. Okay. C sits to the immediate left of B. Now, we have given that we have to put C and B together because C is an immediate neighbor of B, and in this case here is only one case where we can put C and B together. Okay, that case is here. Okay, C sits immediate left of B, So if you put C here, then B should be here, because we have to satisfy this condition as C sits to the immediate left of B. Okay, B is here and C is on the immediate left of B. The one who lives in Surat sits second to the right of C. So second to the right of C will be here. So Surat, the person from Surat will sit here. Now D neither lives in Pune nor Kochi. Okay, if D neither lives in Pune nor Kochi, then obviously one place is left for D, that is Jaipur. Okay, because D is neither from Pune nor from Kochi, and only one place is left out, that is Jaipur, will be assigned to D. Now F does not live in Pune. Okay, F does not live in Pune, so only place left for F is Kochi. Okay, now we have given that E does not live in Lucknow. Okay, E does not live in Lucknow. E cannot be here, so he E must be here, because only place left for E is here, and the person remained is G, will be will sit at this position. Now only one city is left out, that is Pune, so C will be from Pune. Now let's see questions. Question number 17 says, who is sitting second to the right of the one who lives in Kochi? So who is second to the right of Kochi? First right, second right. So B is second to the right of Kochi. So answer for question number 17 should be option 4, B. Question number 18 says, which of the following statement is true according to the given arrangement? And if you read all these statements, then all these statements given here are true. Okay, so the answer for question number 18 should be option 2, because all these statements are true here. You can pause the video and you can recheck this statement whether they are true or not. Question number 19 says, 4 of the following 5 are alike in a certain way based on the given arrangement and hence form a group. Which of the following does not belong to that group? G, Surat. Okay, G, and here Surat is here. C, Mumbai. C, Mumbai. Till now you have guessed the arrangement, how they are arranged. H, Pune. H and Pune. B, Aurangabad. B, Aurangabad. F and Jaipur. Okay, F and Jaipur. C, here the person is assigned to the city of opposite, city of the person who is sitting opposite to him. Okay, so see, G is assigned Surat. G is assigned Surat, and Surat is the city of the person who is sitting opposite to him. Okay, so this is correct. C is Mumbai. C and Mumbai. Okay, and B, Aurangabad. You can see here, Aurangabad, B, they are opposite. F and Jaipur. F is here and Jaipur is here. Both are opposite, but Surat and Pune are not opposite. Okay. Pune is here and H is here. Okay, so answer for question number 19, that is odd one out from among these options, should be option 3. Question number 20 says, who amongst the following lives in Mumbai? So we know that the person who lives in Mumbai, he is E. So answer for question number 20 must be option 2.